main engine start. 2, 1, booster ignition, and the final liftoff of Discovery.
Rocket science is knife-edge, sensitive technology. Harnessing an explosive chain reaction for propulsion has its pitfalls. And not enough energy or poor design...
A duck.
...means you don't get off the launch pad.
1.
But how did the gummy bears and their sinister black vapor trail perform?
Boom!
After finding the landing site...
Beeping is good.
That is beautiful.
It's the mythical moment of truth. It flew. It's true. But how did it perform compared to real rocket fuel?
So when you decode the altimeter, it says that our gummy bear rocket got up to 3,691 feet. That's pretty respectable.
Only respectable?
Some gummies flew, man. They ignited, they shot into the sky, flew almost 3,700 feet into the air. That was awesome. What does it mean? Is it time to break out the champagne and call NASA about our new rocket fuel? Let's slow down just a little bit and take a look. Here's the thing. The whole point of real rocketry is to maximize thrust and efficiency to get the largest possible payload as far from Earth as possible. So the discovery of a rocket fuel that is less efficient than the fuel we currently use, it's not really cause for celebration. It's more a reason to celebrate rocketry's flexibility, let's say. I'm going to say this one is plausible.
Yes, the sweet mythical snacks, carefully combined with a potent oxidizer and binder, had enough energy for liftoff. But in such a high-performance technology, 82% is merely viable and barely successful. Cue the Heinemann.
Well, it was fun, and it actually worked. But let's face it, there's not really any practical reason to use it. There is, however, another fuel that, on the face of it, might seem just as frivolous. But in reality, it might just have a practical use in future space travel.
Oh. All right, you might be forgiven for thinking Jamie has lost his marbles. But allow me to explain. What makes a rocket fly, what makes a good rocket fuel, is a hydrocarbon because it burns well in the presence of oxygen. And poop is a hydrocarbon. Back in the shop, Jamie did some calorific testing of poop versus rocket fuel.
2,916 calories per gram.
Even though it was several orders less efficient than rocket fuel, it's a lot easier to find than gummy bears. Up on the rocket, it's being made all the time. And on a rocket where every gram counts in terms of the energy expenditure, he might just be onto something.
So after all that nasty, smelly, disgusting, doggy doo-doo, we end up with this sleek carbon fiber beauty right here.
So there we go.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first poo rocket coming out of MythBusters.
It's time to pronounce my poop rocket prediction. And I want to get this right because I don't want to poop the bed. I mean, rocketry is something that we do. So I'm here to say that I think that while the poop may launch, I don't think that our number two solution here will become our number one solution.
Mind if I set this one off?
Not at all. Be my guest.
The standard rocket fuel control nearly hit 4,500 feet. How will Jamie's no-waste waste fuel compare?
All right, this is it. Poop rocket, the final launch in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, there it goes. Oh. Yeah! Whoa, that's beautiful. Dude. It's got a very appropriately dark smoke trail, doesn't it? Jamie. That was really respectable.
Yeah.
That was fantastic.
Well done, little poop rocket.
Okay, so the telemetry is telling me that we got 2,900 feet. That's pretty respectable.
Respectable? It's downright phenomenal. I mean, I know it didn't go as high as the gummy bears, but that was never the point. The fact is that it did launch. Here's the thing you need to know about why poo is amazing. It's always going to be there, and it's totally useless.
If you're on a long space voyage, every gram counts as far as your payload, so you're going to want to recycle as much as possible. With something like urine, it's not so hard. You can filter it and treat it and then drink it again. But with poop, it's not like you're going to be able to process it and then reconsume it. We have, however, shown that it might just be a viable rocket fuel. Who knew?
You heard it here first, NASA. Or maybe you already thought of it.
Probably did.
Bunch of smart guys. Now, we got to call this before we go. Gummy bears and poop as rocket fuel, how do we find?
Well, I think it's pretty clear. They're both plausible.
I think they are. Let's get out of here.